A different set of numbers from yesterday's special Senate election in Massachusetts is leading to rejoicing from Republicans here and across the country. Scott Brown's surprising victory over Democrat Martha Coakley is being framed by many as a national referendum on the president and his health care reform plan. That is certainly how state GOP chair Luke Esser sees it.
The celebration last night did not stop at the boundaries of the state of Massachusetts. It really was a national election with a national reason for celebration for Republicans and for those concerned about the irresponsible governing of the Democrats and the arrogance that they've shown.
Democrats concede the election is a blow, but they are conceding nothing in the debate.
Health care continues to be a priority of the president's. It was yesterday, it was a year ago, and it continues today.
We will move forward with their considerations in mind, but we will move forward.
But without the filibuster-proof 60-vote supermajority they once held in the Senate, something that might dramatically alter what health care reform could look like.
And local lawmakers are also reacting to the vote and what it means for health care reform.
We can get this done, not as nicely as we would have done it in a straightforward manner, but if they make us break it up into pieces and do one piece now and one piece later, we'll get it done.
But Eastside Republican Congressman Dave Reichert disagrees with Seattle Democrat Jim McDermott. He says the vote signals the need to go back to the drawing board and start over.
State Democrats are